Hello, my dear viewer. Today, I'm going to tell you a story about a poor gypsy baker and his struggle for love. It has been told to me by my old grandmother when I was only little, and I still remember it as clear as it was yesterday. The story took place in the deep forests of Siberia, in an old town of Radozhny, which has since acquired even more legends and stories. Peaceful old place, bursting with life and rustic beauty. Early autumns are especially beautiful in Radozhny. As the nature is getting ready to fall asleep, the countryside gets a tint of autumn warm yellows and reds. Many wonderful people live there, and today's story is going to be about one of them. Boyka is a baker. He lives just behind the next corner, and there is his house now. Day of the normal baker starts very early, but Boyka is not one of them at all, as he is a bit of a lazy gypsy. Though an inventive one. It all starts from ingredients. Flour, sugar, eggs and butter. And of course his favorite thing, the poppy seeds. Poppy seed buns are his best seller. There are only a few people in this village who haven't tried it yet. It is all thanks to the doohickey baking machine he has constructed. It is funny how industrial progress in Russia is spurred onwards by the desire to sleep for a little bit longer. All he needs to do is load the ingredients, smile, press the button, and head for his delivery van to make his rounds. Mornings are such a nice part of the day in Radozhny. The air is full of early morning freshness, mixed with the smells of wildflowers and singing of the birds. Boyka starts his deliveries at the local market. As the lovely place is full of funny characters, pretty ladies and all sorts of bits and bobs for sale. He unloads his truck and continues further through the town. Today, he has a new stop on his schedule. One rich merchant has ordered a big batch of cakes and cookies for his forthcoming shindig. More customers, more monies. That is what Boyka always says. When he knocked, the most beautiful woman has opened the door. In her hands, there was a gentle poppy flower of vivid red. When their hands touched, Boyka's heart has skipped a beat, but he has understood that their hearts were beating in unison. Little did he know that her husband was standing right behind her. He was not a very nice man, as among his many flaws, he had a few anger issues. An easy mistake to make, to start on a gypsy, though only a few make this mistake more than once. An angry drive home, and 5 minutes later, and Boyka had a perfect battle plan. He was going to dig a tunnel and nab the merchant's wife from under his big nose. Digging took a lot of effort, I must admit. But there are no many barriers that love plus anger cannot overcome. What a man got to do, a man got to do. He will succeed, or his name is not Boyka Khadraj Rusak. He got inside and whispered, "Babe, let's run away together. I'm a good man, and the love of a good man is worth a lot." What Boyka did not realize was that his entry has alerted the husband, and he was not a happy bunny. What the husband did not take into the account was that Boyka still had his shovel. So they run. They run through the village and its outskirts, saying goodbye to the place they called home for such a long time. They run through the forest and the marshes and the rivers and the hills, until finally they manage to find a place which they could call their own. They were so happy together that every day they planted a poppy on the top of the hill, and that is where the story takes its name. The Poppy Hill. The end.
Thank you.